Hey guys, what's up? Michael Antonovich with Swapmoto Live here for this SML show presented by OGIO Powersports and Yamaha. Joining me today, Dylan Woodcock. Dylan, you know, as a British privateer over here racing US Supercross, but so much more to him than that. Stuntman, traveler, all these other things, party guy.
Yeah.
There's a lot here. So over these last few weeks, we've gotten to know you pretty well.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming by.
Yeah, no worries. Thanks for having me on the show. I watch it all the time at home.
Oh, do you really?
Yeah.
I watch the vlog. The vlog is good.
You like it?
I do like the vlog.
See, we was worried about people wasn't going to like it, but a lot of people like it, and a lot of people that we think wouldn't watch it, watch it. So it's good.
Okay. Why you're here to race 250 Supercross. A lot of people know you from last year's injury at Houston.
Yep.
We'll touch on that, but how's it been to be back here under different circumstances this year and really getting that US experience?
Yeah, like I've been here a few years before, but like every time I come, I always get a little bit better or I get a little bit more help or something like that, you know? So this year was good for me, coming back after an injury and getting a bit of attention through that, but obviously it wasn't good. But yeah, this coming to America is pure enjoyment for me, you know? Like if I have a bad day, I'm like, it doesn't matter to me. Like, I've got no one to answer to this. I just do it with a guy from England, California Motocross Holidays, Mickey Carter, and then was meant to ride for All South this year, and then there were some family issues there, so then she was kind enough, Abby, to give me the bikes and let me carry on and do my own thing with sponsors and stuff like that, so that's super nice of her. Like, and her family always comes first, so you got to fully understand what she done and the reasons why she done it, you know?
Yep. You're finding out firsthand how welcoming the US motocross industry is. You know, the UK's got everything. You have a huge group of supporters over there. Even the UK media that comes over here for those first few races, always cool to see how you guys interact.
Yeah. Yeah.
But big statement of the support system that you have from Seven to Abby at All South, CMH.
Yeah,
it's cool to see everybody pull it together.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like, I only met Abby like a year ago, and now I've got two bikes that she's give me and a set of suspension. Like, I've never had three bikes before, you know what I mean? Someone like that doesn't really know you, gives you a shot, you got to respect what happens and what goes on, you know? So super thankful to her, and obviously Mickey from California Motocross Holidays. I've lived there since I was 15, 14, and I met him at a track. Like, I didn't even know him, but I just knew he was English, you know? And he kind of took me under his wing, and every time I've come here, I've been with him or been with people that are around him, and he's a super nice guy. And he's like bike coach, life skills, all that type of stuff. And I've been coming out here living on my own young and been like, oh, I don't really know what I'm doing. So I'm going to go ask Mickey, or like, I'm going to call, like, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, super cool. And obviously Seven, Roger and Dennis and all the guys at Seven, super nice people. Like, when I walked there, when I went in there, he'll laugh at this, but I went in there 2 weeks before the first round last year, and because of COVID, I never come to practice. I walked in there, I sat down, and he was like, "Oh, what's your name?" He's like, "What's up?" And I was like, "All right, mate." I was like, "My name's Dylan Woodcock." He's like, "Oh yeah, I've heard of you. How long you been training for?" Like, I'm like, "I haven't ridden yet," and he just like was like, I think he gave me like two sets of gear or something.
Yeah.
And then after I made the main, he gave me a few more sets, and now we've got a sick relationship with Dennis and Roger and all the guys there. So yeah, people in America like to help, and it's you can appreciate it when you do good and you go back to them and say thank you, and then there's so much, like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like a bounce back effect.
You're a breath of fresh air, I think, for the US industry, because you see it from a whole different way.
Yeah.
I talk to like Lewis Phillips and the guys at MX Vice all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
What you guys do over there, the support system that you have, it's not as big as it is here, but you guys still give it 100% effort.
Yeah, 100%.
To come here, you guys are always so appreciative of everything.
Yeah.
You want to see where the stuff comes from.
Yeah, yeah.
You know.
But I mean, it's everyone. If anyone says in England they don't want to come to America and race, they're lying.
Yeah.
Look, we've been riding today, the bikes, I'm going to jet wash it off, it's going to take me 10 minutes. You go riding this time of year in England,
you're done.
3 hour job.
Yeah.
And you're doing it in the dark, your hands are cold, everyone will know what I'm on about. It's disgusting, you know what I mean? And I think it just puts a bit more of a dampener on it, almost, like, because here you got this show, good show, everyone watches it from back home. England, it's not so much, because it's like there's not enough time in the day for all the riders to do it.
Yeah,
it's nuts. And I spend a lot of time in like Glomal and stuff like that,
yeah,
trying to be a motocrosser or be this GP guy, and it's just hell.
That's important, and I want to talk to you about that.
Yeah.
Because you're not the standard moto guy. This is not like trying to live the dream, like,
oh,
you said,
no,
living on the facility at Lamo in some little apartment with a race shop that dumps into the sand.
Yeah.
Two things. How many times have you been to the US, and then what made you want to come here the first time?
I come here when I was younger on a Cobra, Minios, because okay. I was sponsored by Cobra. That's why I come. And then I always loved Supercross, and I was racing loads and loads of Supercross, and Aaron Nixon from Monster, mm-hmm. I was riding for like Cowie and Monster, and I was bugging him, like, I want to race Monster Cup, can you help me? And he gave me the opportunity. So we come race, and then that's when I met Mickey. And then I kind of come every year after that, because like I said, in England or Europe, it's raining, it's miserable. So I was mm-hmm. coming here, doing a bit of training, going home, doing a bit of training before the races and so on. And I think I've been coming every year bar 2018 or 19, I can't remember which one, mm-hmm. but like only for like a week, you know, because like COVID times and stuff like that. But I always try to do it. I know it's never going to last forever. And the sooner you realize that, I think the sooner you get to enjoy it more. Each year you come, there's always someone new or something happening that's different, and I enjoy it, you know. This is pure enjoyment for me. So when I'm here and I do good, it's like I just pat myself on the back, because it's a sick feeling.
Okay, the big thing that so many people know about from last year is the injury at Houston. Mm-hmm. Not to touch on that too much, because that is just a small part of your whole story that, you know, and you've done interviews about it already. Check out Pulp MX for that. Mathis did a great job with that conversation. But to come back from that, how has that been, and how rewarding is it to be back to where you were, if not a little bit better now?
Yeah, it was good. I mean, the A1 didn't really go to plan for me with the issue that I had and smashing the bike up that much. I guess mm-hmm. no one would have really got it, but all the guys that was with me helped me. And then the injury last year it's never good to get hurt.
Yeah.
But like, even my dad would tell me, like, ever since I've been hurt, I've been a different person, you know? I appreciate stuff more. I want to do stuff for myself more and others and stuff like that. And it changes you when you get that close to almost changing your whole life, and you're that close to something like that happening. It's not good. Like, I'm still not really 100% with the feeling in my toes and stuff like that. So, yeah, you just learn to live with it, and it could always be worse, you know?
Mm-hmm. What was it like to go from being here, completely foreign country, place you'd never been, because I doubt you spent much time in Houston, Texas.
Never.
To getting back home. Was that a big...
I was lucky. I was lucky because, like, I speak... Brian Moreau was here a mm-hmm. few weeks ago, and he got an operation done in Houston, mm-hmm. where I got hurt.
Oh, okay.
So I'm like, that's kind of a lucky thing. I never even knew that. And then people from, like, Road to Recovery was helping. And then luckily, a guy that was riding last year for Abby from All South, when I first met Abby, because that mm-hmm. was the first time I ever met her. And then he actually lived, like, 30 minutes away. So I was lucky enough to stay there because the races were like free on the bounce.
Yeah.
It was like a race, 2 days off race, 1 day off race. And I just got to know him. Luckily, the Thurman family, like, they looked after me.
Oh,
like,
it's Curran Thurman?
Yeah.
Curran's awesome.
Yeah, his whole family are cool. Mm-hmm, like, mm-hmm. even to the sister, to the sister's boyfriend, like, they come pick me up from the hospital when I couldn't even, like, barely walk, you know? And they was like, they was doing schoolwork and stuff, like, making sure I was all right. I don't know these people from Adam, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah, that was good. Getting back home, obviously seeing my mum and dad, and they was a bit like, because I've only seen them, like, over the phone, and every time I pick up the phone, they're crying and mm-hmm. so on. So it's not a good time. But once you start walking and stuff like that, like, me and my girlfriend, we was walking, like, 1 mile, 2 miles, 3 miles, and then we run, and then she never started coming because I was going early and trying to run, and you know what I mean? Like,
back to
everyone had their little job to help me get back to where I am, and I'm so grateful for that. So,
last thing on this, almost 365 days to the day.
Yeah.
You're back on the starting line at Oakland for the main event.
Yeah.
How was that? Was that an emotional thing, or do you just put it into the back of mind because you're in the moment there?
You know what, ever since, like, when I first got here this year and started riding, I was a bit nervous on, like, the whoops and stuff like that. And once I got that down and the whoops and stuff like that, when I sat on the line at A1 and I didn't make it, I was like, oh, maybe it was an easier coast or something like that. Mm-hmm. In Oakland, I was pissed because obviously I never made it out of the heat and I was so close, and then I slipped off. So the hole shot was great for sure, because I'm not really known for a hole shot or mm-hmm. something like that. And then to make the main was, that's why I give the big fist pump, you know, because it's like a weight off my shoulders almost.
Cool. We got so much more to talk about. Hey, set back through this commercial break, and we'll be back with more with Dylan Woodcock. Hey guys, Michael Antonovich here with today's SML show with Dylan Woodcock. All right, so now we've gotten over the injury, come to America, all these things. Let's talk about your big backstory, which a lot of people don't know. You're a stunt guy.
Yeah.
How do you, this is what pays the bills. So how do you get involved in the stunt industry in England?
I'm only a small stunt in the stunt. I'm not even on the stunt register yet.
Okay.
So like I'm training to be a stuntman, but like obviously once you get training and you're specialized in bikes or cars or like that's the kind of what I specialize in. Mm-hmm. You get odd days here and there, so you need six disciplines and I've only got two, so I'm like a ways away, and you need to be like a rider in each one. Mm-hmm. You know, but I've been around the film industry for a lot of years. With my dad's a stuntman, a stunt coordinator, and he's a super professional guy, so that's where I try to get it from him. Like we butt heads sometimes because he's like straight and narrow, and so like, you know what it's like with my dad, you know?
Yeah.
But I've been around it for years, and I love the film industry, and I never really got into it until like a year or two ago, because I was so focused on the big dream, you know, to be a MXGP rider or something stupid like that. And I just kind of said to my dad, I was like, we're not gonna do it, so like, we need to figure out. And then I said, I wanted to learn to be a stuntman, you know? So still got a long ways to go, but I'm enjoying the process and I love it, you know?
It's so funny that you say that, because when you told me that a couple weeks ago in Oakland and I met your dad, I was like, oh, that makes sense. There's another father-son duo, because we know so many. The Day in the Dirt race that's at Glen Helen every year, that's what that whole race is about, the stunt guy thing. There's so many of them in moto, especially here in Southern California. Yeah. Have you gotten to know more people through that?
I know Rich Taylor. Mm-hmm. I think Wagerman's done some.
Yep.
Yeah, and I've seen him. I've seen stuff in the movies where I'm like, I recognize like the EKS goggles and all stuff like that. And I've known Rich, he sponsored me when I was younger, you know? So yeah, we know them, but we've never actually, or my dad's never, I've only just got starting to get into the games, you know? So he really loves America and he would love to work here and do stuff like that. So yeah, I think he's had a little look around this year, and it's completely different. It's the same as the moto industry as it is there. Things are different, people are different, and it's just, yeah, so.
What's a day on set like? Even though your stuff's still been pretty limited, completely different than I think what people would expect.
Super professional, super professional. It's like this, what you've got here, it looks professional, everything's on time, there's a schedule, you can't be late, you can't be ill, you can't be sick, you got to act professional. You got to be good at what you do, otherwise you shouldn't be there. It's a whole list of things, and everyone plays their part in the movie industry. Like my dad's girlfriend is in like she does like the clothes and like she does all stuff like that. So she's in the industry, she plays a part. My dad does that. We all like, everyone has their own little part they play. So it's a crazy setup, like it's nuts.
Is it hard to ramp yourself up to do some of this stuff? Like, are you still scared about certain things? Like you told me earlier, if you get hit in boxing stuff, it's a problem.
Yeah.
But there's other stuff where like, hey, that's not a big deal. I can crash a motorcycle on command.
Yeah, that's why there's like special E's, and everyone has everyone has one special E on the British stunt register, you know, like everyone has their own like one skill. And obviously mine is gonna be bikes eventually, because that's what I've grew up doing. So when someone tells me to do something on a bike, I can do it, you know? But if someone was to say to do something on like something that I wasn't that good at, obviously you'd get nerves, but as it comes, you get used to the cameras like here, you know, you get used to it. You've done loads of shows, I'm sure you're used to it. And then, yeah, you get used to it.
Yeah, it's one of those things, like even with this, the first couple times you do it, you're like, oh shit.
Yeah,
and then you feel like you open up, and then like, hey, it's second nature now.
Yeah. But I love it, you know, and I've got a bit of a plan where I'm gonna try race Supercross and do like a skill or two skills a year and still enjoy myself in England and kind of be a 21-year-old British boy, you know, enjoy life, party a little bit, do my work, do what I got to do, make enough to make a living, and hopefully I can come here each year and ride for good teams or have support and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm just kind of taking it year by year and kind of do that plan, stunts in the summer, here in the winter, and just kind of see how long I can do it for until I can say it's enough, you know.
21's young, you got some time.
Yeah, it's young, yeah.
On set, have you met people? Like, what's it like to be around, you know, not only the movie stars and all that, but the producers and these people that you know that your future's in their hands, how you impress them is gonna go on? Because it's the same thing as riding into the stadium at Anaheim 1. All these team managers, all these sponsors are there, and the impression you make on them is gonna determine your future.
Yeah, I guess when you're on it's like now, we're acting professional, and you gotta do that when you're on the set, you know? So I've been around a lot of the people that are like producers and Stumpy. I've been around them since I was tiny, and they know me from BMXing in the on set or being the Lenny's dad's son, you know? So when they see me now, I got a beard and long hair and a bit scruffy on the edges, they're like,
You grew up.
Yeah, you grew up. So you get respected different. And the stunt industry, you get a lot of respect from all angles and all sorts of people. So yeah, I'm enjoying that path. And it's like, I wouldn't say a second life, but like, you know, you've always got
Something else. Options,
yeah. So it's not all about dirt bikes all the time. It's not all about doing 2 hour road cycles and all that type of stuff, you know? There's always other stuff that I get up to and do. So I enjoy it a lot.
It's got to be nice to have two sides of everything. Like you said, the stunt thing and all the money you make does fund this to come here and do that.
Yeah.
And then hopefully in these next few seasons, how well you do merits enough support that this can run itself too.
Yeah, I mean, when I was younger, my dad was just like, we rode for teams and stuff like that. And he was just like, Dylan, it's not gonna happen. You're not gonna do it. So you need to think of a plan B. And coming here and doing the stunt thing, I'm not doing that much work, you know? It's more like getting my skills so that I can be an established guy. So I'm just earning enough money to pay my rent at my flat and pay my bills and have fun. If I wanna go partying one weekend, I will, because I've not got to worry about a race, you know? And then, yeah, coming here, I have a lot of great sponsors that help me do it. From England, from here, all them types of stuff. So I wouldn't say it's all off the stunts sort of like
paychecks. It's all running itself.
Yeah, I'm just kind of just making sure I get by and trying to live this dream for as long as I can, so.
Okay, I like to hear that even as a 21-year-old guy, you have the perspective of, I'm not gonna wake up tomorrow and all of a sudden I'm gonna be Supercross champion. You know, like, hey, just enjoy it. Enjoy being a cool young guy with the opportunities that you have, and go do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good to hear.
Yeah, I enjoy it, you know. It's just, you see a lot of kids and they're just like butting heads all the time with their fathers, or they wanna go live that life, but they know they can't because of sponsors. But if you show people you can do it and still race, I think it's number one key. Most importantly, you gotta remember why you started this, and everyone started it for the same reason, is to have fun and have as much fun as possible. So if you can do the other stuff and still do this, win-win.
Hell yeah, that's what I love to hear.
Yeah.
All right, we got one more commercial break and then we'll be back with Dylan Woodcock.
Adventures on hold. But now is the perfect time to prepare for their return. Amsoil has your back with fast, free shipping, and ordering has never been easier. Just look up your vehicle, select your product, add an oil change to your cart, and check out. Spend $50 on Amsoil products, and shipping is on us. Order now at amsoil.com.
We'll be right back.
Hey guys, welcome back. Michael Antonovich on the SML Show with Dylan Woodcock. All right, we've talked about how you got here. We've talked about the stunt industry. Let's talk about the California Moto experience, because you boys have enjoyed this to no end. Like I said, I like watching the vlogs, seeing you guys at the practice tracks, but all the people that you've gotten to know, just what you see being around Elsinore, Paulo, State Fair, the tracks, it's cool. What's your favorite thing about being in Southern California?
Honestly, I would say how easy it is to go ride. Like, it's easy. You literally load up the bike, go there, pay your money, go there, come back. You don't even have to wash it sometimes. I'd say that is like the, and obviously the weather, is just a massive, massive plus.
Right.
I'd say, honestly, that is the only reason. It's like, obviously we've grew up in different places, so we miss home or miss foods or stuff like that, but it makes up for it in different areas. But obviously everyone misses that one food or something like that, so.
It's part of traveling, part of being that 20-year-old something guy that's going out there and finding it. Favorite place that you've been since you've been over here?
To eat?
No, not just in food, but just in general. Has there been some place that you guys have gone?
I quite like Texas.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, when I was in Houston, I really liked it there. They do like a lot of like meats and like brisket and all that type of stuff, and I just liked it there. I thought it was more like as close as you could get to home. I think here it's just so like, it's hard to do anything if you're not 21, you know, without going like out or doing something like that or getting around places. It's traffic and all that type of stuff. But it's just getting expensive here. Every year it gets a little bit more. A few more pennies go on the list, so.
Okay, when you go home and you're back in England over the summer, is there something you're like, I can't wait to get back to California to do this? Not riding, but just to go out with your friends or go see something?
Do you know what? I've never spent a summer here. So I would really love to go to the beach like and surf. I like surfing, so I'd like to go there and just surf in like the sea would be a little bit warmer, I guess, but obviously not hot, but it'd be, I'd like to see it all packed because every time we go, it's been
it's empty.
So yeah, I'd say that.
All right, favorite food then? What have you liked?
I like Chick-fil-A.
Okay.
I do like it. I'm just gonna say, Chick-fil-A is pretty good.
Okay, food you miss most from home over here?
I'd say Nando's.
Okay.
Nando's is bomb, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. Everyone in England goes Nando's.
Oh yeah,
so
when you guys had that shortage, I saw the
Yeah, no, there was
the
no chicken.
Outs. Yeah,
there was no chicken, so everyone was just getting the sauces and making it homemade.
I went to the Ozex Open down in Melbourne a couple years ago.
Yeah, they have one there, right?
Yeah, and that was like everybody's go-to. It's like, we have to go around the corner, like, screw practice, screw the autograph signing, we're going to Nando's.
Right now. Oh, mate, it's bomb. Yeah, I love it, I miss it. That's probably the first thing I'm gonna do, because there's one on the motorway right near my house, so I'll probably stop there with my girlfriend, get one of them, go back.
All right, the people you brought over, who's part of your crew this year? I met your dad, you have a vlogger here, which is awesome.
Yeah, got Jake from This Media, he's filming. So I brought him. I've known him since he was younger, but we never knew each other. So like, and then as we got a bit older, he actually come here my first year of Supercross, and apparently there's a photo of me and him, but we can't find it. And like, he's got a photo of me, because obviously he's English, we're English. And then we got mates, Bobby Bruce, Sam Ongley, and Ongley family. That's how I met Jake. And then he literally turned up to a track one day and he was a little bit hammered. I wouldn't say he was a little bit. He's like from the night before, you know?
Yeah.
He turned up and he was just like, I just thought he's quite funny. So I just went, what are you doing? I said, do you fancy coming to America? And he was like, yeah, 100%. And I was like, oh, are you joking? A couple of months went by, I rung him back and he comes. So yeah, him, my dad, my girlfriend, Mickey, Megan, his wife, they've just had a baby, Jax. I'm sure Jax will be doing something in a couple of years to help us. And all the sponsors that help us get it, it's been great.
It doesn't seem like it's very hard for you to convince people, hey, we're going to the US, so come with us. It seems like all you guys are like, no, we're going on holiday too.
Let's a dream. And I think most people know if they come with me or something like that, it's not just going to be all riding, you know, we have fun as
there's
well.
There's fun,
yeah. There's fun involved. And if there's a day off, we'll go do something. If there's not stress and you're not trying to fix bikes or something like that, because I do the mechanics, the training and all that type of stuff, so yeah.
Okay, you're 21?
Yep.
What clubs are better, over here or over there?
Oh, wait.
Way over. Agreed. Yeah.
It's 100%.
100%.
Yeah, there's not even a question about it.
Okay, where's your favorite place to go party at over there?
In England?
Not in, just in Europe in general.
I only really partied in England, but I guess like Ibiza or something like that once it all opens. I don't want to go when it's not open, but like we go to a place called 93 East.
Okay.
It's like a rave place. It's pretty legit in there.
We went to this one in Italy one time. We went to the after party after the race, and then we went to another after party in this like outdoor party, like industrial area,
yeah.
and we watch the sun come up, and I'm like, we're not doing that at the US races, no. we're only doing it over there.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
guys know how to have a good time.
Yeah, we know how to have a good time, like Germany and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's amazing.
I think I got roofied at the Geneva Supercross one time. Yep, yep. So you guys, it's honestly my favorite part of yeah. going over to Europe in those downtime races yeah. is just the fun that happens after, because you guys see the balance of like, we worked so hard, was blowing
and
off a little bit.
I think when people come from like, like America to Europe and they party for the first time mm-hmm. and you see them actually like let themselves go, it's brilliant. Like, I won't mention any names, but I've seen it happen a couple of times. I've been in a German after party, looked at my watch, seen the time, and they're like looking at their watch thinking this is not the normal time we're meant yeah. to be out. So yeah, it's funny.
All right, being around California and just seeing the stuff, what's the riding like compared to what you are used to? Like you said, the dirt doesn't get as, you know, it doesn't tear, or not no. stick to everything and make it as messy, yeah. but completely different skill sets.
Yeah, yeah. I'd say here the jumps is perfect. Like you mm-hmm. can case a jump here, get away with it. There's a lot of runoff spaces. In England, they're trying to cram tracks in, and even Europe, like a lot of tracks have like rope or like something around them. If you come and hit the rope, that's not going to end
done.
Well. Yeah, you're
yeah.
done. So yeah, I'd say that, and the tracks, because everyone's riding them all the time and it's not a full-time job in England, like the tracks are not open in the week, mm-hmm. they're only open at weekends. I think like the jumps and stuff in England are not as big as they are here. And Supercross, not, like it's unheard of in England, really. Like a legit Supercross track. We have arena cross tracks
yeah.
and obviously the arena cross series was around and people are still doing that now. Like there's a Steelhawk one, they do it, but like, it's not like a legit Supercross track where there's proper woods, proper sections measured, you know, so it's a, yeah, I'd say that's the biggest difference. And a lot of guys have raw speed here. In Europe, yeah. like they have raw speed, but like I say, more like I wouldn't know how you say it, like the race is like 30, 40 minutes, you know, mm-hmm. so it's like.
So it's more endurance.
More endurance. Yeah. I think as riders go, they get into it here.
Yeah,
I think they start good and end the other way, you know, so. Yeah, some of the raw speed these kids have here is a joke.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy. You see them go around the track and I'm like...
Is it, okay, knowing that there's not a lot of Supercross stuff out there, is it yeah. a big shock for you when you get back here? Like, is there a big transition period in those first few days?
There is and there isn't. I try to ride some in the summer if I get a bike from a manufacturer or something like that. I try mm-hmm. and ride as much as I can and set the suspension up, but I'd say it's good just to get your feet wet and ride. Like, in the summer if I ride, we go ride and go home, on the way home, we stop at the pub, have a few pints, and then we go back home, you know? It's
yeah,
just
yeah.
good fun, and when you come here, I think once you're into a rhythm of being like a professional racer or whatever you want to call it, or professional fun ever or whatever, you get into a rhythm, you're riding, you're training, riding, you're training, so the flow just comes back, and you take it easier for a few weeks, and then you're back into it, you know?
Cool. Hey, dude, thanks for coming by. It was
yeah,
awesome to hear. You got a couple more weeks here, a couple more rounds.
Yep, yep.
And then we'll be on the lookout for you coming back soon.
Yeah.
It's cool to know, like, there will always be a place for Dylan Woodcock.
Yeah.
You're going to come back here. You got a lot more years left.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're only going to keep progressing.
Yeah, no, thanks for having me. I love this show. You know, like I said, I watch it all the time. And hopefully we can keep coming back and doing good.
Well, next year when you come back, we'll do another episode.
Perfect.
Thanks, bro.
Cheers, mate.
Thanks for watching this episode of the SML Show presented by OGIO Powersports and Yamaha. I'm Michael Antonovich. We'll see you guys soon.